गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ग्लोब्स एंड मैप्स। वी ऑल नो आवर अर्थ इज़ राउंड इन शेप एंड वेरी लार्ज इन साइज। ड्यू टू इट्स स्फेरिकल शेप एंड लार्ज साइज वी कांट सी द होल वर्ल्ड एट द सेम टाइम। ओनली वन हाफ ऑफ द अर्थ कैन बी सीन। इन द पिक्चर वी कैन सी फर्डिनेंड मगेलन हु वॉज अ Portuguese explorer went round the earth that the earth actual shape was known. Globes. A globe is a small man-made model of the earth. It is a simple and accurate way of representing the earth. The maps on the globe show the correct size and shape location of the places in relation to each other. Then the advantages and limitations of using a globe. The advantages of a globe are, first one, it helps us in studying geography. It helps the pilots and sailors plan air and sea routes. A globe helps us to understand the happening of day and night. These are the advantages of a globe. Now, limitations of a globe are, it is difficult to carry a large globe. On the globe, the space is limited and details cannot be shown. And the third limitation is, we can't see the whole earth on the globe at one time. Then maps. The word map comes from the Latin word mappo, which means a napkin, a cloth or a sheet. A person who makes maps is called cartographer. And the book of maps is called an atlas. The art of making maps is called cartography. The art of making maps is called cartography. A map is a representation of the earth as a whole or a part of it drawn to a scale on a flat surface. A map is more useful than a globe. But it has some limitations. It is not possible to draw a curved surface on a map. Map of a small area can be fairly accurate. These are some limitations of map. How map is useful to us? First one, maps provide a lot of information. Map can be easily carried around in bags and pockets because it can be rolled and folded easily. Maps are of different types and each map contains different types of information. And we can preserve information in maps. Then types of maps. There are different types of map. First one is physical map. Physical map show us the physical features, like mountains, plateaus, plains, etc. Political maps show the political boundaries like towns, cities, states, capitals are shown on the political map. Next type is thematic maps. Thematic maps shows the distribution of soil, crops, forest, temperature, etc. And some of important thematic maps are, climatic maps provide us information about the climate, rain, snow in an area. Next, economic or the resource map show the type of natural resources, economic activity, etc. Topographic maps include contour lines to show the elevation or height of an area. Road maps show the roads, railway tracks, airports, and these help us to find our way about in a new city or town. Here in India political map, we can see different types of states and capitals and boundaries. And in another map, India physical map, we can see the physical features like mountains, plateaus, plains, coastal areas on the physical map. Then language of a map. People who make maps use different signs, symbols to show various things on a map. This is known as language of a map. Then direction. There are mainly four directions that are depicted on a map are north, south, east, west, and these are also known as cardinal directions. North direction is always at the top of the map. South direction is always opposite to north, and to our right is always east direction, and to our left is always west direction. And in between the north and east, there is northeast direction, and between the north and west lies the northwest direction, and between the south and east lies the southeast direction, and between the south and west lies the southwest direction, and these are also known as intermediate directions. Then scale. The scale of a map is defined as the ratio between the distance shown on the map and the actual distance on the ground. For example, the ground distance between two cities is 400 km. But it is not possible to draw 400 km on the map. So we can represent 400 km on the ground on a map 4 cm. Here, in this case, it would be written as 4 cm equal to 400 km. The ratio between the distance on the ground and the distance on the map is known as scale of the map. And a compass rose is an instrument that helps us to find direction, and its needle always points towards the north. Colors on a map. Different colors are used on a map to show various things on a map, like water bodies are shown in the blue color, plains or lowlands are shown in the green color, agriculture lands are shown in the yellow color, highlands are shown in orange, and shades of brown. So different colors are used on a map to show the different things. Then signs and symbols. Different symbols and signs are used to give information on a map. For example, a dot within a circle marks capital cities. All maps have an index key, and this key helps us to understand what the symbols and signs stand for. Like in the picture, we can see the different symbols. Like post office can be written as PO, and police station can be written as PS. And these are some signs and symbols used on a map. Some symbols are used universally all around the world and are referred to as conventional symbols. So students, read this chapter carefully, and if you have any doubt, you can contact me on my WhatsApp. Thank you.